Hi lovely, so this is what we have. This is twist on my thinning hair and it just looks so scanty. So I'm all done rinsing now. And my hair is super soft and still very shiny. I went ahead to start twisting these with the leave-in conditioner. So this is what it looks like. Okay, so I've quickly done this side of my hair off camera. And there's something about this leave-in conditioner that always makes me want to twist, like make really small twists. But I resisted the urge, and they're not particularly mini twists, but this is the size of twist that I did at the back. And then the front is a bit smaller than the back, but at least I was able to finish twisting this side within 30 minutes. So that's out of the way. And I'm
going to do this side.
This side. Okay. So I'm going to be doing this side now. I'm going to show you a couple. Let me divide the front from the back. So this is the front section, which will be smaller than the back. But I just simply will put everything up. Okay, so I simply unravel the twist and put some leave-in conditioner on. So because my hair is thinning and the top half is thicker than the bottom half, I make sure that I twist it as firmly as possible to blend both of them in. And I also find that twisting smaller helps to conceal the difference in the thickness of my hair. So you'll see when I take down the twist that it's not too obvious that my ends are thinning. Yes, the volume of my hair wouldn't be as big as it used to be, but the ends of my hair wouldn't be sticking out like a sore thumb. In case you're wondering why I'm wearing gloves, it's because one, it helps my nails not to break my hair unintentionally, and two, it literally like helps me make my hair faster. Can you see how fast I'm twisting? Like super fast, and there's honestly less breakage. So I started this recently and it's been a game changer. So the difference in the thickness is not so obvious. As you can see, everything sort of just blends in when it's a smaller twist. But then when it's a larger twist, it's very obvious. So, and I don't want people to keep asking me, what happened to your hair? What happened to your hair? So it's just easier. So if my ends get a bit dry, I just take more leave-in conditioner and apply it to the ends of my hair. So on any part of my hair that is really thin, I just like do a finger coil. Honestly, I don't twist to the end, I just do a finger coil and then leave it be. So I'm going to do the rest off camera because it's getting dark, and hopefully when I'm done I can show you what the whole twist would look like, okay?
Hi lovely, so this is what we have. This is twist on my thinning hair and it just looks so scanty. Like it looks so scanty. It's exhausting. Alright, so I'm gonna begin to take it down so you can see what it looks like when it's loose. But we're gonna do a 360 as well so that you can get the feel of it. So you can get a feel of it, so.